Welcome, welcome to the Golf Ball Addict 2022 Golf Ball Awards. So we're at the end of the year here, we're getting to the holidays, and I am kicking off what is going to be quite a few videos of my end of the year top honors for golf balls, golf equipment, golf tech, things I've reviewed, things I've seen throughout the year, and we are starting today with our Golf Ball of the Year line. This is going to be the top five two-piece models of the 2022 year. So if you're new to the channel, I want to go ahead and give you a heads up. One, I do swing 93 miles per hour with the driver, which is pretty much the average. The average is about 91 for, you know, males in America. I don't know about overseas, but that's about the average swing speed. So it really is for the average golfer. So if you get on here and you wonder why the Pro V1 ain't on here or any of these like TP5Xs, it's because my golf channel is centered around the average golfer. And the second thing I do want to go over is that in these categories in the top five for the two-piece models, basically they're going to come down to four categories that I reviewed them on. One, of course, being performance. How well does the golf ball perform? You know, how does it do? How were the numbers? Were they fantastic? Were they up and down? How much forgiveness did it have? Things like that. Then, of course, there's design of the golf ball, which is how does it look? Does it look like a premium golf ball? Does it look cheap? You know, what's the outer cover rate of? Does it have a good alignment tool on the side? Things like that, like its marketability. Next up, of course, is durability, which is going to be, you know, how well the golf ball performs. Does it last you 18 holes, or after 9, is it pretty scuffed up and ready to be tossed out? And then last but not least, and this one's really important, and it definitely decided knocking a few golf balls down and up, this is value. So if you're new to my channel, again, value is really important. Not only is getting a top performing golf ball really important to a lot of people, but getting it at a price that doesn't completely wreck their wallet is also very important. So there were a couple golf balls that, you know, were a 5 out of 5 on performance and a 4 out of 5 on durability and a 5 out of 5 on design, but they might be the most expensive golf ball, and that pretty much takes them all the way down, and it might knock them down a few spots. Without further ado, let's get in to the top five golf balls two piece of the 2022 year. Number five, the Mizuno RB566. Now, the unfortunate news is this golf ball has been taken off the market because I believe Mizuno is coming up with an updated model for 2023. I just don't know when it'll come out yet. But as far as the 2022 model, I think it's actually the 2020 model. If you can still get your hands on it, it is really a breath of fresh air. It has a unique design to it there. It has the blue. It has little tiny holes in the dimples. It just looks interesting. It looks modern, but it also performed extremely well. It got top marks in every category as far as performance. I didn't have any issues anywhere. All the clubs seemed to perform really well, and it had some really top-notch durability. But the reason it ended up fifth was, well, just like I just said a minute ago, the value wasn't that great. They do charge about $23 to $25, you know, for a dozen of them. And when you get into the $2 per golf ball line, when you're talking about a two-piece, that's pretty expensive. It's about as expensive as it gets. So that's kind of what knocked it down. Number four. The Maxfly Straight Fly is a great golf ball. Now, it didn't perform as well as the Mizuno. You know, I gave it about a 4 out of 5 on performance, but it did go very straight. It eliminated a lot of hooking and slicing, which is really good. The durability held up extremely well. And then overall, the design was really good too. I love what they've done, you know, as far as their logo. I love the alignment tool that's on the side there. It really helps align putts a lot better. I think Maxfly just did a really good job overall, and they're headed in the right direction. And I had pretty much, I would say, one of the best results with this particular golf ball. So I give it massive credit there. And then here's the thing, as far as the value goes, you can get them for $19.99 a dozen, but if you buy two, you can always get them 2 for $35, and that's a really great value. So that kind of helped it edge above the Mizuno. Number three, the Pinnacle Rush. Yeah, I know. I was surprised too. Listen, when I tested the Pinnacle golf balls, I wasn't expecting much. The Pinnacle Soft didn't do as well for me just because I think I was compressing it too much. But as far as the Rush goes, with my swing speed, it honestly did really well. It had a lot of pop. Honestly, the performance was a perfect score. The design did take a little bit of a hit there because you can see it's just an old design and there's really not much of a alignment tool at all. So that's definitely a little hit. But then durability was honestly fantastic, and its value is amazing, coming in at 15 golf balls for $20. Really good price point there for golf balls, especially two-piece, lots of value. And I was pleasantly surprised. The Pinnacle Rush is definitely something I don't mind using on the course, and I've been telling a lot of my friends and colleagues about it as well. It is legit. It shouldn't have that same reputation that it's had in the past. Number two, the Wilson Zip honestly was so forgiving. It was one of the most forgiving golf balls I had ever played with, and the numbers were out of this world. I had multiple people tell me before I reviewed this golf ball how great it was and how I should try them. I never really bought into it, but then when I finally did, I couldn't believe I waited so long to test it. Honestly, it had perfect score as far as performance, perfect durability, and its value at $29.99 for 24 golf balls is just about as good as it comes. Unfortunately, the only thing that kept it out of the top spot was that the design of the golf ball leaves a little bit to be desired. There's not much of an alignment tool, and I'm not really a fan of this style of Wilson logo. Most of the time, they use a more classier logo like on their model golf ball, and this one just felt a little cheaper, a little gimmicky. Other than that, though, it's a great golf ball, and I recommend it to anyone. It just performed so well. Honorable mentions real quick. These are golf balls that I put in the running. They just fell a little short. The Top Flight XL, the only Top Flight golf ball really that performed even semi-decent. The numbers were really, really good, but unfortunately on design and durability, they fell pretty flat. Of course, there is the value there from Top Flight, but with those two categories in the middle falling pretty flat, it just kind of kept it out of the top five. The Titleist True Feel as well. So I had okay performance with the True Feel. It was a little roller coastery, a little up and down, but it did have a really good design to it with a great new alignment tool. The durability was exactly what you'd expect from Titleist. And then honestly, the value is really where it hurt it, because it's $25 for a dozen, and that is the most expensive two-piece golf ball mainstream-wise that you're going to see on the market. So unfortunately, because its value is so low, that's what kept it out. The Precept Laddie and the E6 both get an honorable mention from me, but actually they got kept out of the running for two separate reasons. The Precept Laddie's numbers off of the clubs were incredible, one of the highest I had tested at that point. Unfortunately, the design of it is just so old. It looks like a cheap, old 90s style golf ball. They haven't really done much to update it in many years. It needs a complete remodel. So design there was really a downside for it. And also the durability just really did not do as well as I would have liked either. I understand it's a very cheap golf ball, but its value was incredible. You can get them for basically a dollar a golf ball. So because of those two categories, again, it fell off. And then actually the opposite on the E6. The E6, it was really the value. Again, one of the lowest values. It's $24.99 for a dozen golf balls, just like the Titleist. Really the most expensive, and that value is just what kept it down. But they do get honorable mentions. Number one, and my two-piece golf ball of the year, is the Cut Red. Honestly, this ball got a perfect score from me across the board. Its performance was incredible. It does an amazing job of feeling great coming off of, whether it's your pitching wedge or your driver, the feel is unmatched. And not only that, the golf ball does prevent, or at least help reduce, slices and hooks. It goes straight almost every single time. If I need to hit a nice straight drive, I have the confidence of knowing I can put it down and just hit it, and it just goes. It's amazing. The distance numbers were incredible. It spun really well. It held a green. It was awesome. And then its design is really cool. I love Cut's logo. I love what they do there. And Cut was honestly ahead of the game on this. They started doing this alignment, you know, thicker block quite a few years ago. I would say like 4 or 5 years ago. And so they've been ahead. So I'm hoping they update it just a little bit for the coming year. But for now, this is still an excellent alignment tool on the side. It's simple. I love that they put the little Cut logo in there, the word Cut in the alignment tool. And then as far as durability, honestly, after about 70, 80 shots, I couldn't even find any scratches on it. It was just incredible. And then as far as value goes, you can get 24 golf balls for $20. You can get them under a dollar a golf ball. You can find this deal at Walmart. I think they are going to go up just a little bit because of inflation this year, but you're still going to get them for under a dollar a golf ball. You can't beat the price. You can't beat the performance. Honestly, without a doubt, it is my two-piece golf ball of the year. Well, that is segment one. Tomorrow, I will be coming out with, it'll either be tomorrow, it'll be the next day. I don't know how I want to space them out. It just depends on how well this video is doing. But the next one up will be my tour, my value tour top five as well. And that's going to be for golf balls that are in the middle there. You know, they're not quite the Pro V1, but they're like the value tour, you know, things like that. So we'll see those as well. Guys, if there was a golf ball that you thought deserved to be in the running, maybe I just didn't test it yet, but I would love to hear about it. So please comment down there what you guys love. Tell me your top golf balls. And if I missed any, feel free to recommend them. I would love to test them out for the channel. As always, keep watching to keep saving, keep learning. Until next time.